We'll hope so. So did you say you got it working? What was it?
They're the same exact size.
Huh?
They're the same exact size.
What are
they? Pads.
Oh, you're not talking about the air conditioner?
Oh, no. I went to change, trying to get my parking brake so I can get it inspected.
Oh, okay. Okay.
It failed me. Three times.
Oh.
Okay.
Did you get it worked, fixed?
That was my main thing, then my air conditioner.
And then you got, so you didn't work on your air conditioner anymore then. I thought that was to take the pulley off your air conditioner with. I thought that's what you wanted that breakable belt for.
Oh,
no,
I was trying to get the bracket to take the calipers off.
Oh, okay. You got this on the back too?
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
I got a parking brake. Shoe inside the hub.
Oh, I never seen one of those. I've heard them talking about them.
And it's the same exact size, but it's working. You know, I push it to the floor and it really wouldn't hold it real good.
Yeah.
It failed me and I took them off, tightened them up.
Yeah.
Took it back there and she failed me again. So oh. I can't pass it. I let my time run up.
Yeah. Oh, then what happened?
Pull back in, first thing they see, fix that parking brake.
Yeah.
Well, you might ought to just go on and act like it never came.
Is that what they said?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We can fix it.
Yeah.
I figured it out. I don't know why, but they recalled 2 or 3 years on that truck.
Yeah.
But they would only recall it on a standard.
Is that right?
I said, well, manual automatic transmission, the main reason for a park is to make it not roll.
Yeah.
And the first thing they say when you get inspected, if you're on a hill and it rolls, it's a park.
Yeah.
So it is just a way for GM to not have to pay for
all of the
defect for that parking.
Yeah.
They did manual transmission, they recalled all of them.
Uh-huh.
Automatics, they didn't recall.
Huh. I get why they're just trying to get out of it, but heck, when I did drive a manual, I put it in gear, either reverse or first gear. And now maybe you forget to start it in gear, but it'll just jump a little bit. Well, I mean, back then. Nowadays they won't start at all. They got a switch, an automatic switch. They won't even turn over.
Their main concern is if you get stuck on a bridge, it's an incline.
Uh-huh.
You don't have a parking brake.
Yeah, but if you got in gear, that'd hold it better than a parking brake. So it's the automatics that's a danger because that parking brake is weak. It's they've always said there was a plastic parking gears that hold it in place. The park gear, and they'll brake easy. And they say don't depend on it. Use your parking brake.
Yeah. Well, I think the main thing that they did is there's a clip that you got to get it inside to the bottom.
Uh-huh.
Because when you push it, it expands.
Yeah.
And I think it kind of raises up.
Uh-huh.
And it does some expanding grip.
Uh-huh.
And I put the new shoes and that new clip on it.
Uh-huh.
And there is a big difference.
Oh, okay.
But the size of the shoes are exactly the same.
You mean the thickness of them? The old ones aren't more.
I've set one on top of the other and I said, it's the same thing.
And maybe it's that clip you're talking about that makes a difference.
I think that's the main thing, really.
Yeah. Yeah, if it's doing like that and not, it's going like that and it's flexing instead of opening it. I've seen things do stuff like that.
It works. I gotta admit, it works.
Well, that's good. I finally got my horn fixed today, and then now I'm trying to get, well, my grill was missing 2 screws, and so I'm trying to get it back in there better. But I finally figured out my horn. It was the ground. It was so corroded and rusty that it wasn't getting any ground. So I fiddled around with testers and all kinds of crap for a day and a half. And finally, I figured out, well, the grill's not that hard to get off. I couldn't get to it, I didn't think. I figured out there's only six screws holding the grill in. I didn't really look at it good enough, you know. Got the grill out and I could get to it.
Let's see. Two, three. Okay, we're gonna cut that right there. Can I see it? Where's my mark? Oh yeah, last time I did it. I'll just use my measure. I was using this as a stop last time, so maybe I'll see it if I get it in the right place. My mark didn't show up. Okay. 1-3. I actually remember that for some crazy reason. 1-300. It's not that critical. But it is critical that you get tight on it. I'm gonna mark it again. It's gonna be tricky. There's my old mark. It's not show up good. I'm still gonna try to grab it. Well, if I grab it while I'm looking at the mark, maybe I'll be alright. My right hand's the one that just does that best though. Actually just runs the right up into the area where you can cut. Do you know you can cut bolts with that part right there? I forgot about that. You can actually do that when they're not too worn out. This part right here where I'm putting my finger in, making it dark if you didn't know that. But I'm not going to do it now because it really boogers them up on the end, and that was easy to fix and make to where I could screw it in there. If it leans over on me, it won't. That tube, there's only a tube before there, and if you go in too far, you don't get anything on the tip of that clamp. There's some good all thread. Need some short pieces. Okay, man. Ah. Thank you. I might have got it. In there. Now, if I can get lucky enough to get that other one back in there, I sure wish my clamp would have held. There it is. It starts good. A lot shorter. Ah. found another one of those holders on the ground. But I bet you that's one of them that I thought was grabbing. So it's a good thing I'm doing this, but boy, this left one is hard to get hooked up. I was so close, I think. Keep working at it. Here's a trick I think I might be able to do. I've done it before, I just started up. There's just nothing that'll go in there that I've got, that I can think of, that will hold it. You know, something that'll bend sideways and all that. But what I do have is a finger that'll bend. So I'm gonna tape, since that's long and skinny, I've taped bolts to my fingers before. I'm just gonna tape it to this finger, I think. And see, since it's like that, I'm not showing it. Since it's like that, long, big old butterfly bolt, maybe I can hold it up there. Get to the screw. The other one, I pushed it up against the hole and just got lucky and hit the spot and put the screw in. The screw is actually tightened itself into that plastic. That hole's not as worn out. And I can't get it out. And I might be able to get it out if I keep trying to try. But if this works, I'll be fine. Because it still spins. It's just stuck down in the far as it'll go. digging into the old knuckle and hurting, so and I can't hold it in the right place very long. Let's try it with this. This finger will reach it from the bottom. It's the only one. Let's try it with that one. Maybe. I'm having to do it completely by feel. I can't see. So maybe if I get that straight like that and try to hit it. See, that's what you count on, especially if it's really best to use masking tape. I was thinking it might not be strong enough, but see, that's what you want. You want to be able to break it to get it off when you get it there. You want, and I guess tempting as it is to use a drill, you will hurt your finger bad if you do that. Because it'll grab, especially with this kind of weird little nut, it will grab that thing wrong. And you could break a finger. I was able to twist it pretty hard with the screwdriver, just like that. Trying to get it started. Finger's not strong enough for that little prolonged amount of pushing. Ow! You don't have which fingers has the most strength that way? Try it one more time. I can get it in the area. I can't think of anything else. I've done that with regular bolts, and like you could tape it to your finger and then poke a hole where the bolt itself is. This one spins in there, so it makes it even double tricky. And I can't put it, I might put it up there, and all the way up over it, but it wouldn't make it not spin, but But it kind of helped me. See, it's kind of funny. Like, if you got a screwdriver in one hand and a bolt on the other finger, in the other hand, you kind of naturally line them up. And you can actually hit things blind like that. But it's offset like that, makes it a little more tricky, I guess. And with it spinning, it makes it even more tricky. But can't get it to stay where I want it. Anyway, I'll try it again like that. And let's see, from the top, because my other finger is hurting too much to press on it anymore. Keep trying. What I was able to do is press and then be able to get that bolt out of the hole and then or out of the slot and then go like that. And so maybe I can do it. backed up once, but it's cross-threaded. Ew, that starts turning. That's harder. Yeah, I need something about that can grab it. I've got something, but I don't know. It's a real flexible thing. It's got little pinchers that go out of it. It's like a probably about 3-inch tube. I don't see how in the world that thing could work. It's the only thing I got that could go up in there from the bottom. I do have that magnet. See, that other thing wouldn't hold it very good at all. This magnet, you know, it's, I don't think it would hold it long enough either. But try it like that. Tried that for a long time. Let's try it like that. That would even actually hold it straight. If I hit it just right and it's not cross-threaded, I might get it started like that. might have completely ruined it this time. I've bent it a lot. I've bent it before, I think, and straightened it out, but it's creased real bad. Now it broke. Dang it. They wouldn't have made us such cheap crap. Okay, got it started. Now if I can just get it all the way down, my hands are killing me, that hand is killing me. If I can get it all the way down without, you know, grabbing on both wings, I'll be alright. So, something. I want to use the drill to run it in faster. Around Friday, it'll just mess things up. I think I'll try it on. I don't know if I want to do this one or another one. As long as I don't go hard at it, I guess I could even. Still has a pretty good torque for a little screw like that. Let's put it on. I've got it on 21. So. The clutch, I hate them, but in this case I'll try it because I don't want to break my little thing. Okay, let's take this stuff over there. Let's see. Yeah, I've got all the tools I need, I think.